Hello, science explorers, it's Justin again, and welcome to the Savanna. We traveled a long way from the forest to get here, and so far the weather has been a lot warmer than what we're used to in the other biomes. Ooh, did you hear that? These wide open grasslands are home to some large animals. And they're predators. So we'll have to be very careful and alert while we explore this vast landscape. The African savanna, where Mia and I are, stretches for thousands of miles. So we'll be cruising through the grasslands in this safari vehicle. Ready, Mia? Okay, let's go. Mia, do you have a driver's license? Oh. As you can see, one of the main characteristics of a savanna is grass, and lots of it. The savanna biome is a type of grassland that also has trees and shrubs. Savannas are mainly located in three parts of the world: in South America, Africa, and Australia. Do you notice anything about the part of the globe where these areas are located? Yes, they're all very close to the equator. Remember how the ocean water is warmer along the equator? Well, the land around here is much warmer too. This means the seasons here are different from places like temperate forests that have four distinct seasons. Instead, the savanna only has two seasons, the dry season and the wet season. During the dry season, the savanna can go months without any rain at all. How do you think this impacts the plants and animals here? Plants wither, watering holes dry up, and many animals struggle to find fresh food and water. On the other hand, the wet season brings monsoons, months of torrential downpours that help the grassland burst with life once again. It sounds to me like the plants and animals that live here have to go a long time without any fresh water. I wonder how they get used to living in such a harsh environment. Whoa, check out these huge trees over here. It almost looks like they're growing upside down. Like the roots are on top where the branches are supposed to be. I wonder how it grew to be so wide. Ah, Mia says they're baobab trees. These trees store water in their trunks so they can survive the dry seasons. They also produce fruits that are rich in moisture and vitamins. Baobab trees provide shade, hydration, and nutrition to the animals that live here. Because of the long stretches without rain, what kinds of animals do you think might struggle to live here? Amphibians like frogs and salamanders who need moisture would not thrive in this dry environment. But if you're a mammal that feeds on grass, the savanna is the place for you. Let's see what animals are grazing in the grassland. These wildebeest look a lot like cows. Look at their horns and the way they munch on grass. These herbivores, or animals that eat only plants, graze on the grass alongside a herd of hundreds of other wildebeest. Even when the grass withers during the dry season, they can still eat it, no problem. It looks like these mammals are on the move. Where do you think they're going? We learned back in the forest that birds sometimes migrate or move from place to place with their species to find warm weather. But what could these herbivores be looking for? Pause the video here to make a prediction in your field notes. Large herbivores like wildebeest, zebra, elephants, and gazelles migrate to find fresh grass and water. They follow the rain alongside thousands of their kind to find watering holes across the savanna. Ugh, looks like something startled them. What do you think they see? Uh-oh, looks like there are lions on the prowl. I could barely see them hiding in the grass. With these large groups of herbivores come carnivores, or animals that eat mostly meat. Big cats like lions prey on these herds and have to be very sneaky to do so. Sticking to the herd provides safety in numbers, but what else can these herbivores do to evade these predators? Whoa, look at them go! Gazelles, another grazing herbivore, use their speed for protection. These deer-like mammals can run up to 60 miles per hour. That's as fast as a car on the freeway. What is this thing? It has feathers and a beak, so it must be a bird. But it's huge. These birds are too big to fly, but look how their long legs can run. They must be ostriches. Ostriches' strong legs can help them escape the clutches of carnivores and deliver powerful kicks if they need to defend themselves. It's easy to spot all of the large animals living in the savanna, so now let's look out for the smaller creatures living in the tall grasses. Ah, I see something. It's a meerkat. These ones are on the lookout for predators. If they see something, they'll signal to the rest of its group to go back into their burrow. Meerkat families live together in these intricate tunnel systems that stay much cooler than the hot grassland above. These little guys mainly eat insects. But what kind of bugs are crawling in the grassland? Wow, what could have built this? It almost looks like a sandcastle. Oh, this is a termite mound. Termites are insects that are a lot like ants. These clever invertebrates have discovered how to keep cool above ground by building these special mounds. Air moves through them so they stay cool despite the hot, dry days. Termites are a food source for meerkats, as well as other small mammals and birds in the savanna. What a wild adventure we've had today! It seems like these plants and animals of the savanna have developed a lot of ways to survive this unique biome. Was that Mia? You see another animal? Huh. I don't see anything. Can you? Oh, there! It's a cheetah! Wow, it's totally hidden into the grass around it. Next time, let's look more closely at the big cats here and how they blend into their surroundings in the savanna. Thanks for exploring with us today. Remember, the wildest discoveries are yet to come. Until our next journey, science explorers!